Greetings to one and all. Let us sing this hymn as it is screened. The verse for today's meditation is taken from the book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. This is a common verse that we all came across from our childhood. But what does it actually mean when it says the fear of the Lord? The term fear itself is not an optimistic term. Then why does the author King Solomon refers the fear of the Lord? Here he means not a fear or a terror or begging fear, rather a reverential fear, a fear that a creation owes to the Creator. Today I would like to bring a biblical character in front of you to quote this reverential fear. We all know the life of Joseph. Today, Joseph is the one who had this reverential fear towards God. His fear, as recorded in Genesis 39:9, "There is none greater in this house than I, neither had he kept me back and anything from me but thee, because thou art his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God?" We all know the life of Joseph. We all know that in this passage, Joseph's master's wife allows him to sin with her. But Joseph say no to sin. A fear, indeed a sensitive act of fear towards his creator who is greater than his master and his master's wife. A fear that enables him to say no to sin. The love for his God enables him to have such fear. Apparently, there is a contradictory fear exhibited by another person in the Bible, the fear which has not been exhibited by Joseph. It is exhibited by his father, Jacob, who ran away in terror of fear of punishment for stealing his brother's birthright, the only blessing of the firstborn. And this terror saves him all the way to hide in his uncle's house. This fear terrified him even after decade departing from his house. Such kind of fears are not being pleasing by God. God doesn't like these kinds of fear. A fear that tells us to hide ourselves from the Creator and His creation, that is a human. A fear, a terror that sin against God. Even there is another example in Bible who had this fear. It's Adam. Adam sinned against God and hid him after committing sin. God never pleases such kind of fear. God expects a reverential fear, a fear that honors God, that glorifies His name alone. It is also an healthy and sound fear. To biblically support the idea of reverential fear, I would like to read Proverbs 8:13. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride and arrogance, and the evil way and the forward mouth do I hate. King Solomon demonstrates a clear structure of fear, is to hate evil. Just as Joseph loved God, as a result, he hated evil. Even in our life, we may forced to have fear like how Jacob and Adam had. These kinds of fear are common among us. We may have fears when we have our exams, to take decision, to start work, or to move to a new environment. Such kinds of fear are common among everyone, every human. In our everyday life, we fear to our higher authorities, teachers, parents, and any officials in power. These kinds of fear are reverential fear towards the human that encourage us to be a disciplined life in their inspection. But as a child of God, what kind of fear does God require from us? It is the fear that how Jacob and Adam had, or is the fear that Joseph had? But it is a fear that we need to keep only on God. My friends, let us take a second to examine ourselves, to check our life. Do we fear the Almighty, all-powerful, omnipotent God? If so, do we realize that every step of our life is inspected by Him who created us? Do we honor God in all our works and commitments? Do we live a life that exhibits a reverential fear towards God, which enables us to hate evil? Is our life in any way or in any line with Joseph's devotion and love for God? It is time for us to introspect ourselves. To whom do we fear? Do we fear the God, or do we fear evil? If we fear evil, it is like disobeying God. If we fear God, then it shows our love and reverential fear to Him. So let's take a decision today to be like Joseph and show our reverential fear to God. Let's pray. Our precious loving Heavenly Father, Creator of heaven and earth, we thank Thee for giving this new day, O Lord. Bless each and every one of us, O Lord. Let us have a fear like how Joseph had on You. Let us keep our full fear to You, and so that our life will be in a proper way. Bless our principal, teachers, and all non-teaching staffs of our college. Bless each and every one of us, O Lord. Let Thy name alone be glorified. Amen.